we showed that no matter the underlying distribution of a dataset, the sample means would be normally distributed with a mean equal to the original mean, and a variance equal to the original variance divided by the sample size. All right, this lecture will be concise and has the sole purpose of defining what a standard error is. Put bluntly, this is the standard deviation of the distribution formed by the sample means. So how do we find the standard error? We know its variance, sigma squared, divided by n. Therefore, the standard deviation is sigma divided by the square root of n. Let's continue our example from earlier. By extracting a sufficiently large number of samples from a random data set, we obtained that their means are almost normally distributed, in accordance with the central limit theorem, and their variance was equal to 3,171. As we already said, the standard error is the standard deviation of the distribution formed by the sample means. Given that we already have its variance, we can simply take the square root of 3,171 and divide by 5.47, because we extracted 30 samples and the square root of 30 is approximately 5.47. So we obtain a standard error of 10.3. The standard error shows the variability between the means of the different samples we extracted. You can guess that since the term has its own name, it is widely used and very important. Please note that the standard error decreases as the sample size increases. This makes sense, as bigger samples give a better approximation of the population. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.